गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडेज टॉपिक इज आईलिड्स एंड लैक्रिमल अपैरेटस। द लैक्रिमल अपैरेटस, इट इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट एसे क्वेश्चन इन यूनिवर्सिटी, नोट इट डाउन। द आईलिड, इन लैटिन इट इज कॉल्ड पैल्पेब्रे एंड ग्रीक इट इज कॉल्ड प्लिब्रॉन। द क्लिनिकल कंडीशन रिलेटेड टू द आईलिड आर रेफर्ड इन टर्म्स ऑफ ग्रीक। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, द इन्फ्लमेशन ऑफ a margin of the eyelid is called plebritis and congenital absence of eyelid is called apleberon. So what is the function of your eyelids? The eyelid protect the eyeball from direct and bright sunlight, and it also protect from injury. The upper eyelid is larger and more mobile than the lower eyelid. The eyelids are separated from the eyeball by the conjunctival sac. The space between the two eyelids is the palpebral fissure. The two lids are fused with each other to form the medial and lateral canthus. At the medial or inner canthus, there is a small triangular space called the lacus lacrimalis. Within it, there is an elevated reddish body called lacrimal caruncle. Lateral to the caruncle, the bulbar conjunctiva is pinched up to form a vertical fold called the plica semilunaris. The eyelid is attached to the margins of orbital opening. Its free edge is broad and has rounded outer lip and sharp inner lip. The outer lip presents two or more rows of eyelashes or cilia, except in the boundary of lacus lacrimalis. At the point where eyelashes cease, there is a lacrimal papillae on the summit of which there is lacrimal punctum. Near the inner lip of the free edge, there is a row of openings of the tarsal glands. The tarsal glands lies in the inner lip of the free edge. So the free margin of the both eyelid is subdivided into lateral 5/6, the ciliary part with eyelashes, and medial 1/6, the lacrimal part which lacks cilia. Next, coming to the structure of eyelid, the following layers are present in the eyelids from outer to inner side, that is skin, subcutaneous tissue, striated muscles, submuscular connective tissue, fibrous layer, non-striated muscle and conjunctiva. Now we will discuss about the detail about the structure of eyelids. First, skin. The skin of the eyelid is extremely thin and loosely attached to the dermis. It contains sweat glands and sebaceous gland. The large size sebaceous gland and the large sized sebaceous glands at the lid margin are called Zeis gland, and the large sized sweat glands near the lid margin are called Moll's gland. The duct of the Moll's glands open into the hair follicles. Next, coming to the superficial fascia. The superficial fascia of the eyelid is its devoid of fat, and next layer is muscular layer. The muscular layer of upper lid is composed of both striated and non-striated muscle fibers. That is, palpebral part of orbicular is oculi muscles present here. It is supplied by facial nerve, and second muscle is the levator palpebrae superior is supplied by oculomotor nerve. The non-striated muscle is called Muller's muscle, or otherwise called superior tarsus muscle. It is an involuntary muscle receiving sympathetic innervation. The muscular layer of lower eyelid is composed of palpebral part of orbicularis oculi and inferior tarsal muscle. The next layer is, it is a submuscular space. It is a space deep to the muscular layer in the upper eyelid. It is filled with loose areolar tissue. It continues with the subepineurotic space of the scalp. This continuity is responsible for the appearance of black eye in bleeding injury to the scalp. The submuscular layer contains sensory nerves of the eyelid, hence local anesthetic solutions are injected deep to the palpebral part of the orbicularis oculi. Coming to the next layer, it is fibrous layer. This is the framework of the lid. The tarsus and palpebral fascia together form this fibrous layer. The tarsal plate consists of dense fibrous tissue to give support to the eyelid. The tarsal plate of the upper eyelid is bigger and almond shaped, whereas lower lid is smaller and rod shaped. The medial end of the two tarsal plates connected by medial palpebral ligament to the lacrimal crest of maxilla in front of the lacrimal sac. The lateral ends of the two tarsi are connected by the lateral palpebral ligament to the tubercle on the zygomatic bone. That is called Whitnell's tubercle. The tarsi are connected to the orbital margin by palpebral fascia. It is otherwise called orbital septum. The tarsal glands, otherwise called meibomian glands, it is embedded deep to the surface of the tarsus. They are modified sebaceous glands. Their duct open on the lid margins by minute openings. These tarsal glands secrete oily fluid which form a thin film on the conjunctiva. This reduces the evaporation of tears. The inflammation of the tarsal gland is called hardiolum internum. The chalazion is the cystic swelling of the tarsal gland. The upper tarsus receives two tendinous slips from the levator palpebrae superioris, one from voluntary part and another from involuntary part or Muller's muscle. The palpebral fascia, or otherwise called orbital septum, it is pierced by palpebral part of lacrimal gland, fibers of levator palpebrae superioris, vessels and nerves entering the face from the orbit. The next layer we already discussed, that is, it is a non-striated muscle fibers, that is Muller's muscle. It is supplied by sympathetic nerve fibers. The innermost layer is called the conjunctiva. The conjunctiva is a transparent mucous membrane which lines the inner surface of the eyelids and front of the sclera of the eyeball. The part lining the lid is called palpebral conjunctiva. It is highly vascular. The part lining the sclera is called ocular or bulbar conjunctiva. Next, coming to the blood supply, the eyelids are supplied by the superior and inferior palpebral branches of the ophthalmic artery and lateral palpebral branch of lacrimal artery. They form an arcade in each lid. The venous drainage is into the ophthalmic and facial veins. Next, coming to the nerve supply, the upper eyelid is supplied by lacrimal, supraorbital, supratrochlear and infratrochlear nerves from lateral to medial side. The lower lid is supplied by the infraorbital and infratrochlear nerves. Coming to the lymphatic drainage, it drains into the submandibular nodes from the medial half of the lids and lateral half of the lid is into the preauricular nodes. What is muscle of Roiland? So muscle of Roiland, it is a striated muscle fibers at the eyelid margin. It is the extension of the pre-tarsal portion of the orbicularis oculi muscle. Coming to the clinical anatomy, the conjunctiva, that is palpebral conjunctiva, it is examined for anemia and bulbar conjunctiva for jaundice. Conjunctivitis, it is one of the most commonest diseases of the eye. It may be caused by infection or allergy. One is stri, or otherwise called hardiolum externum. It is a localized suppurative inflammation of gland of Zeiss. The gland is swollen, hot and painful, and whole of the lid is edematous. The pus points near the base of one of the cilia. This is hardiolum internum. It is a suppurative inflammation of the meibomian glands. It is associated with the blockage of the duct. Next one is the chalazion. Chalazion is the chronic inflammatory lesion of the meibomian gland. That is, it is a granuloma of the meibomian gland. This picture is pleuritis. Pleuritis is the inflammation of the eyelid, especially the lid margin. Entropion. It occurs inward rolling and rotation of lid margin toward globe. What is ectropion? Ectropion is outrolling or outward turning of the lid margin. And lag of thalamus. It is incomplete closure of the palpebral aperture when attempt is made to close the eyes. This picture shows ptosis. What is ptosis? It is drooping of the upper eyelid due to paralysis or defective development of the levator palpebrae superioris. The oculomotor palsy is one of the causes of ptosis. The partial ptosis is due to paralysis of Müller's muscle as occurs in Horner syndrome. This picture shows scleroplasm. It is the involuntary sustained and forcible closure of the eyelids. What is ankylofibron? It is an adhesion of the ciliary edges of the eyelid to each. Next, coming to the clinical correlation of the eyelashes. What is trichiasis? It is the inward and misdirection of the cilia. What is dystrichiasis? It is the extra row of cilia occupies the position of meibomian glands which opens into the hair follicle. Next common condition is, it is about the eyelashes. What is madarosis? It is partial or complete losses of eyelashes. Scoliosis, it is whitening of eyelashes. Thank you, student. This session is finished.